fix this.
Oh, this hey, is teacher June, what are you doing?
I'm trying to fix this toy. I'm really hoping to get some of these preschool toys fixed this week.
For sure. Is there something I can do to help?
Oh, you know, I would love some help. But I'm really having a hard time seeing in here. Well, it's pretty dark in here.
Look, I got my handy-dandy, like, bright flashlight. Oh. I'm going to stick that. How does that?
Wow.
There it goes.
Oh, that makes so much difference, Carol. Thank you so much. That really helped me see. Oh, let me see. Oh, I think I fixed it. This is looking good.
Excellent. We did it, June. We're such a team.
Yeah.
Doesn't it feel good when something that you hope has been happening will actually come together and happen? Do you feel happy now, June?
Oh, I sure do. Good. You know, I trusted that I could fix that truck, and I was hoping that someone might come along and help me. And you came along at just the right time.
I was here.
But we definitely needed that flashlight, you know? Let's see what toy we can fix next. There's some more here. Let's go see.
There's more work to be done.
Yep, there is. Let's go see. Can you believe it's December already, Teacher
Carol? No, I can't.
I love December. It's such a special month because of what we get to celebrate.
I get it. Wow. There is a lot to celebrate.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that very first Christmas.
Wow, yeah.
People who trusted in God and believed in His promises were really hoping for a new king.
They were.
Someone special that God would send to be a shining light into the world to show them how God really wanted them to live.
That's right. Yeah. I think I get that. Things were pretty broken in the world,
yep.
And there were lots of things going wrong. Kind of like us fixing that truck earlier.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I hoped I could fix it on my own, but I needed help and light to make it happen.
You know, Teacher June, that hope is something you feel when there's something you want to happen, but you don't know yet if it will.
That's right.
So you were hoping you could fix the truck,
mm-hmm.
just like the people in the Bible were hoping God would send them a special king.
That's right. Oh, I love that. And I would also love to read a story about the very first Christmas when God did send that special king. We've been reading from the Story for Little Ones for the past few months. But do you think we could find a different book?
Oh, absolutely.
Story of the first Christmas in it? Let's go see if we can find that book that we can read to everybody. And while we do that, why don't we sing a song about counting on Jesus?
Let's
go, Teacher Carol.
Let's go. Christmas. Now, every Christmas is awesome, but can you imagine what the very first Christmas must have been like? We're going to find out in our story today. Everything was ready. The moment God had been waiting for was here at last. God was coming to help his people, just like he promised in the beginning. But how would he come? What would he be like? What would he do? Mountains would have bowed down. Seas would have roared. Trees would have clapped their hands. But the earth held its breath. As silent as snow falling, he came in. And when no one was looking, in the darkness, he came. There was a young girl who was engaged to a man named Joseph. One morning, the girl was minding her own business when suddenly a great warrior of light appeared right there in her bedroom. He was Gabriel, and he was an angel, a special messenger from heaven. When she saw the tall, shining man standing there, Mary was frightened. "You don't need to be afraid," Gabriel said. "God is very happy with you." Mary looked around to see if perhaps he was talking to someone else. "Mary," Gabriel said, and he laughed with such gladness that Mary's eyes suddenly filled with tears. "Mary, you're going to have a baby boy. You will call him Jesus. He is God's own son. He's the one. He's the rescuer. The God who flung the planets into space and kept whirling them around and around, the God who made the universe with just one word, the one who could do anything at all, was making himself small and coming down as a baby." "Wait, God was sending a baby down?" "It's too wonderful," Mary said, and her heart was beating hard. "How can it be true?" "Is anything too wonderful for God?" Gabriel asked. So Mary trusted God more than her eyes could see, and she believed. "I am God's servant," she said. "Whatever God says, I will do."
Isn't that an amazing story?
It is.
Our story began with an angel and a young girl. God was ready to send a new king, and he sent an angel to give a message to a girl named Mary. Mary was the girl God had chosen to be mummy to his little boy. God gave you to your mommy and daddy too.
Now, Mary had never seen an angel before.
She hadn't.
She was afraid. Can you show me your afraid faces? Those are really good afraid faces.
Mary was very afraid, but the angel told Mary, "Do not be afraid. God sent me to tell you that you are going to have a baby boy, and you are to name him Jesus."
Something else the angel told Mary was that this baby was very special.
Wow. Did the angel explain why the baby was so special?
Yes. Can you tell me why the baby was so special?
You know.
That's right. The baby was God's son.
He was.
And he was the new king that the people had been waiting and hoping for a very, very long time.
Mm-hmm. Can you imagine how excited Mary must have been? She had been told that she was going to be mummy to God's son. She knew how long the people of Israel had been hoping for the new king, and now it was going to happen.
Do you get really excited when you're hoping for something to happen?
Oh, I do.
Maybe you're hoping you're going to get one of your favorite foods for supper.
Wow, or that it doesn't rain so that you can go outside to play on your bike.
Which is pretty good in December. Or maybe right now you're hoping for a very special Christmas gift.
That's right. Now, earlier today, we were hoping to fix some of the toys from the preschool rooms.
They need it.
It was a little tricky at first, but once we got the flashlight, we were able to fix them. Shining light into the dark always makes things much better.
You know, June, that reminds me of something else about the Christmas story.
Oh, really? What's that, Teacher Carol? Can't wait to hear it. What about you? Are you excited to hear it too? Let's hear you shout out. Tell us what it is. Are you ready?
Tell us what it is!
Well, we know that the people were all waiting for the new king. They really wanted someone who could make their world better. Someone who could lead them and give them hope.
Yep.
Just like we saw earlier when we were fixing our toys, shining the light made it so much easier to fix that
toy. It sure did.
Jesus was the hope the people had been waiting for. And he is called the light of the world.
Oh, I see. Just like we needed the flashlight to show us the way to fix the toys, Jesus is like a light that shines to show us the way to live. Wow, I just love that, Teacher Carol.
That is a great message.
Yep. Can you imagine how excited the people must have been that first Christmas? I know I'm excited to celebrate this Christmas and to hear the rest of the story over the next couple of weeks. Our memory verse this month reminds us that God sent his one and only Son. Let's do it together.
We've got this.
Ready?
Right.
God gave his one and only Son. John 3:16.
Girls, this week in your Trinity Kids Box, you're going to find your old craft for this week. You're going to make a night light, a little tea light for yourself. So you'll find your piece of paper with the holes already punched there, some star stickers.
Those are sparkly.
Stick your star stickers on here, and then your big yellow star
going to go
on
right
top.
At the top.
Fold it into a cylinder with either tape or glue. Switch on your night light, and there you have it. Your own little tea light, your own little light to remind you that Jesus is the light of the world.
Let's pray, boys and girls. Dear God, thank you so much for Jesus, who came to bring us hope. Thank you that he is the light of the world. Mm-hmm. Help us to be your light this Christmas. In Jesus' name we thank you, God.
Amen.
Bye, boys and girls.
Good to see you again.
Time.